Hey guys, this is Abhishek from GatherShoes.com, and today we are going to do a quick hands-on review and preview of the Oppo N1 Mini. So Oppo N1 Mini has been launched in India, and it has been launched for a price of 26,990, which is the MRP of this phone. We do have Oppo N1 with us as well, just for the comparison. So in terms of look and feel, both the Oppo N1 Mini and N1 looks exactly the same in terms of how they look it from the front side. So as you can see, we can see that both of these devices has rotating camera. So the rotating camera module is almost the same. We do have 13 megapixel camera on the Oppo N1 Mini as well, just like over here. And again, this one also support ultra HD mode. That means you can actually take photos in higher resolution than high definition, as well as videos. So when we talk about the front camera module over there, we do have LED flash. We do have dual LED flash over there on this one, whereas we have single LED flash. So again, this device has one camera which can be rotated. Both of these devices have the same kind of camera. And when we talk about the back, this is how the back look like. On the back, we can see we have almost the same kind of finishing. We do have a rubberized matte finish on the Oppo N1 Mini, and we have a slightly almost the same finishing. You can say it is also matte finish, rubberized kind of a feel which you will have. Although this one is not that much of rubberized, it is kind of matte finish. Whereas this one is kind of a rubberized matte finish, which you will get a better grip when you hold this device in one hand. And one thing which I have seen, which I have heard from many people out there, that Oppo N1 is definitely a bigger device to hold in one hand. So this device is having a 6-inch display. Again, the display clarity is good enough on this one. Everything is good. This device is also pricey in terms of the price, so it is going to be a costly affair, especially in case you would like to buy this. And this is actually a device which is much bigger to hold in one hand. So one hand usage of the Oppo N1 is definitely very bad. You cannot reach the screen with single hand on this one. So now they have come up with Oppo N1 Mini, which is this. So let me just give you a close comparison. So front module looks the same, and the build quality is again same. And again, on the edges as well, we have followed the same kind of design. They have followed the same kind of design. On the bottom, you have almost the same design. We have the loudspeaker mesh like this. Over here, we have like this. We have micro USB port for data syncing and charging. 3.5mm audio jack on both of these phones. Primary microphone over there. And we do have secondary microphone on both of these phones at the back side of the phone. And on the top, you can see we have the rotating module in the middle. And on the edges on this side, we have the volume button on the Oppo N1 Mini, whereas we have power and sleep key and the volume button both on the same side. We do have a SIM card slot which will accept, a normal size SIM card, but we will confirm that later. It might be a micro SIM as well. On this side, we can see we have the power and sleep key on the Oppo N1 Mini, whereas on the Oppo N1 we have the SIM card slot. So let's take a closer look over the Oppo N1 Mini. This is how the device looks like. This device looks very good in terms of the build quality, in terms of the overall finishing. It is one of the premium device you can actually see in the market. Again, this one is a costly device. Oppo definitely is a newer company as compared to the other brands which we have in the market, and they are going to sell this device for a price of 26,990, which is the MRP. However, you will be able to get this device for a lesser price in the market as well, and we will keep a check on that. So in terms of the display, I can show you that on the front we have this module which can be rotated, and once you rotate this thing, the camera should launch automatically, but as of now, I think that option is not enabled on this one. So this is how the camera view will look like. You can again do a very good quality of video chat from the front camera, or you can say from only one camera on this device, which can act like a front camera and it can behave like a rear camera like this. So you can take a photo. I can just take a photo for you and show you the quality of the same. So we have taken a couple of photos from this device. This is again a photo which has been taken in low light. So again, the kind of colors and the details which you get in this particular device on the photo front is really good. You can see we have good amount of good quality, I would say. Again, details are not very clear, but in daylight you will have much better details. On this photo, you can have actually a better idea of the details. You can see the characters are actually very fine to read, so you do have good amount of details which you can easily notice on this device. I have taken a self shot as well from the camera by rotating it, and this self shot also came out to be pretty good, I would say. Now here we have the camera settings. As you can see, we have a beauty mode, we have ultra HD mode, HDR mode over there. So Ultra HD mode allows you to actually use this device and take Ultra HD photos as well as videos. Let me just show you the resolution. So under the video mode, it does not allow you to take 4K videos. So Ultra HD mode is, you can say just a name. It is not the UHD mode basically. So you have the option of taking videos from this device either at Full HD or at 720p, that is 1080p, 720p videos can also be taken. You have HDR mode in the video supported as well, and slow motion video recording is also supported at 120fps. This is all we have as far as Ultra HD mode is concerned. Let me just go back to the normal mode. So once we are in the normal mode, I can show you the details of the, okay, here we have the video settings, and I can show you the photo settings as well. And for that I need to, okay, over here we have the resolution. So the resolution can be 13 megapixel maximum, which is 4:3. You can actually take full screen photos from this device. Again, they will look like full screen in this case, and that will be 16:9, but the photo resolution will be 10 megapixel in that case. So this is how the camera interface look like in terms of options. So camera wise, this is a very good device. We do have backlit buttons over there. So you do have backlit light, LED light basically below the buttons so that you can see them. However, this light is not very sharp or it is not very bright. As far as the back is concerned, the back is again matte finish. The battery is not removable. That means the battery cannot come out. It is a single SIM device. It is not a dual SIM phone. And as far as specification goes, you have Snapdragon 400 chipset on this device, quad-core processor. This is how the display look like, and again the display is good as well. You do have pretty good viewing angle, so you can see the display from almost any angle without any issues. As you can see, it is an IPS LCD display, and color protection of the display is also good. We have also ran the Antutu benchmark on this device, and I can show you the score. So the score on the Antutu benchmark is 21319. And if we take a look over the bar chart, as far as ranking goes, I can show you the bar chart. So in terms of ranking, this device ranks in between HTC One and Samsung Galaxy Note 2 in terms of the benchmark score. And if we show you the device information as far as specs goes, we have this device, the model number is N5111. Android version which is coming pre-installed on this device is 4.3. You will also get 4.4 KitKat on this device, as they have said that this device has KitKat being tested. So the color OS 2.0 will come on this device later on, within some months I guess, and then you will have KitKat on this device. When it comes to the current resolution, we have 720x1280, which is a pretty good resolution. Text does not feel pixelated on this device. The Qualcomm chipset which we have is MSM8226. And we have 13 megapixel camera on this device. The resolution highest is listed over there. As you can see, you can also do high definition videos on this device. We have approximately 2 GB of RAM on this device, out of which around 1.8 GB of RAM is free. And I can show you the current information about the RAM and other things. Let me just go to again, the UI on the device is ColorOS ROM, which is again quite responsive. You do have all the kind of customizations you would like to see. You have exclusive space over there, which actually lift a lot of other things like widgets and other things. We have live weather wallpapers. You can actually specify live weather wallpaper on this device. Let me just go into settings and show you what all details we have on this device. So when it comes to version of Android, it is 4.3. The ColorOS version on this device is 1.4.0i as of now. We have 1.6 GHz Snapdragon 400 processor, 2 GB of RAM it is, out of the 16 GB memory which we have on this device, which is again which cannot be expanded. We have around 11.48 GB available to the user, and this is the configuration you can say in terms of hardware. When we take a look over the storage, I can show you the current storage scenario. So under the current storage scenario, out of 16 GB, approximately 11.48 GB is available, and the storage used or occupied by each file type is being listed over there, which you can check out in case you would like to see that. And when it comes to the application information, I can show you the current status of the RAM. Again, I'm not sure how much of RAM is actually free on this device. We will confirm that once we do this review once we do the full review of this device. Here we have all the toggles over there. As you can see, we have lock now toggles, we have Wi-Fi toggles over there, you can have screen rotation toggle, flashlight you can enable and disable, brightness is there, and I think automatic brightness is also supported. So automatic brightness is supported on this device, which is definitely a good thing. And I can show you some of the things. We do have some additional gestures also supported. So you have some screen off gestures, screen on gestures. So in terms of functionality and the kind of gestures which you have seen on the Oppo N1, you you will get all the sensors, all the gestures basically on this device, which includes the motion gestures, which includes the glove mode. The screen will also become sensitive once you enable the glove mode, so that even if you are wearing gloves, you can actually use the device. You can also prevent the misoperation. You can use the proximity and ambient light sensor, which are over there. And you have the metallic earpiece, which is also good. And again, in terms of build quality, finishing, material, everything is quite good, quite premium, I would say. As good as you will see on any other high-end phone coming from Samsung or from Nokia. When we talk about GPS location, or you can say assisted GPS, we do have assisted GPS. You can use this device for GPS navigation. You do have support for tethering as well. And again, for that, I need to check over here. So we have support for Wi-Fi hotspot, as you can see. Bluetooth tethering is supported. And again, when we talk about USB tethering is also supported. Once you connect it to a PC, you can actually do that. And when we talk about the sound settings, here we have all the sound settings. You can actually control over the sound of the dial pad, touch, sound, screen lock, power on, vibrate on touch. And when we talk about display, we do have support for automatic brightness, as I already told you. We have wallpaper supported. You can actually download a lot of wallpaper. You can actually also specify different kind of screen lock style, which you can download for free on this device. Again, these are Chinese screen lock styles, and there are some good themes as well, which you might like. So you can actually download these lock screen themes, and then you can set a different kind of lock screen on this device. So you do have the option of changing the key lights over there on the touch capacitive keys. You can actually specify whether they should always be on. I don't recommend you to turn them all on always, because that will actually affect the battery life. We do have the option of changing the messaging ringtone as well. Let me just show you the phone dialer. So again, phone dialer is custom, just like anything else on this device. And when it comes to video call option, we do not have any option of making a video call directly from this device. And when we talk about messaging application, here we have the messaging application. On this messaging application, if you create a new message, this is how the keyboard look like. You have swipe to type supported. The swipe keyboard is already coming pre-installed and enabled, so you can actually do swipe to type on this device without any issues. The keyboard keys are also pretty big in size. As far as display is concerned, the display size is also not too big, not too small as well. It is 5-inch of HD display, 720p display. So pretty good to hold in one hand. One-handed usage of this device is also good. You can actually reach almost every part of the screen without any issues. With one hand, you can actually do that, which is definitely a good thing. And you can actually use this device without any issues. As far as GPU and other configuration is concerned, I can show you the information of the GPU as well. So over here we have the display information, that is 720x1280. And when we talk about the GPU, we have Adreno 305 GPU on this device. And when we talk about the sensors, we have accelerometer sensor, calibration sensor, uncalibrated sensor, some other sensors as well. We do have rotation vector, linear acceleration sensor as well, but we do not have magnetic field sensor on this device. But this device again can be used for GPS navigation, and it will work on this device without much of an issue. As far as weight of this device is concerned, it is around 150 grams, pretty light, I would say, pretty comparable to the other devices which we have in the same price segment. So or maybe less than this in terms of the price, but definitely price is the only thing which is high for this device. Apart from the price, everything is quite good. The bezel is slightly thicker, but again, it does not feel like a heavy phone. It does not feel like a bulky phone. In terms of the weight, it is 150 grams, which is good. The thickness of the device is around 9.2 millimeter, and the good thing or the best thing about the device is this rotating camera. The camera performance on this device has become better as compared to the Oppo N1 Mini, or as compared to the Oppo N1 which we have with us. So we used to get slightly grainy photos on the Oppo N1, and I have tested this device as of now with Oppo N1. I have compared the Oppo N1 Mini. The camera performance is slightly better on this one. Thickness of the device is 9.2 millimeter, again, which is again not too thick, not too thin as well. So pretty good in terms of the thickness as well. So in all, it is a pretty nice device with the kind of features it is coming. The kind of storage it has is again 16 GB. Another not so good thing about this device is that it does not have a micro SD memory card slot, so you cannot expand the storage. So that is something which is going to be there. which is definitely not a very good thing, but this is how it is. As far as sensors goes, we have already shown you that this device does have accelerometer, proximity sensor, and other sensors which you would like to have on this device. When we talk about application which will come pre-installed, so these are all the applications which will come pre-installed. You have slightly good icons, which is again the same color OS ROM which we have seen on Oppo N1. So we have same kind of icons in terms of the look and feel. We do have lock now button application over there, which allows you to lock the device within a single click. We do have some Google application which are coming pre-installed, and over here we can see that we have data monitor. Power saving manager is also there, so you can save the power on this device. You can actually have power saving mode, but ultra power saving mode is not supported on this device. When we talk about other things, we do have OClick. So OClick was the kind of remote which was used to come with Oppo N1. It is still coming with Oppo N1. That will come with this one, but again separately. You will have to buy that for a price of 1890, that is 1890. You have to pay in case you would like to buy OClick as well. If you don't do that, then you won't get OClick. The box content does not contain OClick, and then you can actually install the application and use this little remote which you can buy separately, and then you can take photos remotely from this device. So let's take a look over the box contents of the Oppo N1 Mini. Here's the box, and this is how it will look like. And it is going to look like this. From the back side, we have 5-inch of IPS LCD display, 720p display it is, and rotating 13-megapixel camera, 9.2 millimeter thickness, and weight is 151 gram. So it is again nearly 150 or 151 gram in terms of the weight. And these are the package contents. We will get the Oppo N1 Mini within the package like this. As you can see, this one is the other color which we have seen launching here in India. So there is a white color, and there is this one as well which will come. This one definitely looks different, much different from the other phones which we have seen. So looks good again. We have the SIM detection tool over there with the Oppo logo, and we have some user manuals which will also come within the package. As you can see, these are the user manuals which will come within the package, which includes the information guide, the quick start guide, and then we have these things which includes the USB charger, the universal USB charger. The output current from this charger is going to be 1 ampere, so 1 ampere charger it is. We have the headphones. These are the headphones. These are standard headphones which you will get within the package. So nothing exceptional. We do have a mic module over there, whereas we do not have volume controls on the mic module. And we have a button as well to pick the call. This is how the data cable will look like. And these are the simple things which will come within the package. Packaging is very simple. Much more inspired from an Apple device, just like iPhone. So this is how it will look like. And these are all the package contents of the Oppo N1 Mini, which we have with us. That's all you can do. So in all, this looks like a decent device. To let us know if you have any specific question for the Oppo N1 Mini. We really like this device. The only thing which we did not like is the price. Price is definitely slightly higher, but let's see how it performs in the market. Do let us know if you have any specific question for this device. I would love to help you. You can like this video. This video help you by clicking the like button below. You can subscribe to our YouTube video channel for more videos like this by clicking the subscribe button below. Thanks for watching this video. This is Abhishek signing off. Thank you.